Bitch, now we got Nikki and her dried up ass mama. Bitch, and I usually don't go in on the mamas, but bitch, that hoe don't act like no mama. So, bitch, I'm not gonna treat her like one, okay? Nikki mama pulls out a fucking mugshot of Masika, girl. Yes, bitch, done Googled a mugshot of the girl, printed it out, and bought it to her little meetup with Nikki. That's why I don't respect her as a mama, because, bitch, you being petty. Petty, bitch. What's the tea with that? So what, that the girl went to jail, bitch? Whoa, what's y'all? Welcome back to the channel. It's your boy New Orleans Lil, and this gonna be a review on Love and Hip Hop Hollywood, Season 1, Episode 9. Let's go. Bitch, so the scene opens up where they left off last week, bitch, with Tiara and Nikki sitting there with their mouths wide open, child. So, bitch, they see that it's Masika on the cover of Diamonds, bitch, and they like, girl, can you believe it? Clap, clap, clap. Bitch, throwing nothing but shade. But wait, girl, did y'all see that fucking crab net that Nikki had on? Girl, no fucking ma'am, Nikki. Who is your stylist, girl? You thought that shit was cute? That shit was not cute, my girl, at all, bitch. So they approached Masika or whatever, and Nikki was like, so that's what you was doing when I came? That little photo shoot you had, you was doing a photo shoot for my club or whatever, and you ain't say nothing? And Masika was like, yeah, bitch. I mean, what's the tea? And she was like, I just want you to know that I can have that taken down if I really want it. You know what I'm saying? Talking about how she gonna get the girl billboard taken down and this and this and that. Bitch, and Masika not paying that whole no mind. Like, girl, get the fuck out of here, bitch. Then Hazel E walks up there, bitch. So Hazel was like, hey, so then Masika was like, girl, what the fuck you doing in here? And I done told your ass to get out. She was like, hold on, hold that thought or whatever. So then she asked Tiara Marie, like, what's this I hear that you and Berg supposed to be, like, booed up now? What's up with that or whatever? I don't give a fuck if we is going through something. I ain't never thought that you would do no shit like that. Then Masika was like, well, actually, girl, you did think that she'll do some shit like that. Because remember you told me she was a hoe and she was this and this and that. And then Tiara was like, hold on. I want to know everything that you been telling this bitch about me. So then, bitch, all the tea was spilled, girl. So, bitch, Hazel wound up asking Tiara, why did she do the song? And Tiara was like, because I like the song. Okay? Girl, it got real shady, bitch. Real shady, real dusty, all of the above, bitch. Girl, now we got Amanda, and Amanda pulls up by Fizz house or whatever, furious, bitch, going off on Fizz because she feel played that Monice done snatched her ass up. Bitch, Amanda, you going off on the wrong one, bitch. You should be going off on Monice. Girl, no fucking ma'am, bitch. Monice is the one who snatched your ass up. I know that's Fizz baby mama, but bitch, y'all wasn't even together when you met up with Monice, bitch. And you know, y'all wasn't together, bitch. You still won't meet up with her, bitch. You meeting up with her at your own risk, bitch. And just so happened, she popped you when y'all wasn't together. So, bitch, what you want Fizz to do? Okay? And, bitch, clearly, later on in the episode, y'all gonna see that Fizz can't really do shit about it, bitch. Bitch, okay. So now we got April and Omarion. And, bitch, April, big as a house, girl. April look like she about ready to have that baby now, okay? She to the point where she waddling and shit, bitch. So they trying to walk the baby down or whatever so she can have the baby. And bitch, she take two steps and gotta take a break, bitch. So while she taking her little break or whatever, she expressed that she know that Omarion mama may be a pain in her ass, but she know that Omarion mama cares about him and shit. Then that makes her question her relationship with her mama, because her mama don't show her the type of affection that Omarion mama shows him, child. So then come to find out, bitch, she didn't grow up with, like, two of her siblings, girl. So, like, all kind of shit is going on, okay? Bitch, and, like, she come from what seems to be a dysfunctional family, bitch. So, like, she got her own little issues and her own little things that she dealing with, girl. So now we got Nia and Soulja Boy. And they talking or whatever, and Soulja Boy is wondering, like, what the fuck did Nia daddy think about him? Like, what did Teddy Riley think about him? And bitch, Nia was like, she really didn't know because he never said nothing about it. But let me say this, if he didn't like Soulja Boy or didn't approve of him, you would know something by now. So, you know, no news is good news in that type of situation. So, bitch, next thing you know, you got Soulja Boy playing on this whole bitch, because Soulja Boy telling her they should wait before she move in. And Nia was like, what you mean, wait? Wait for what? He was like, because I'm about to be gone for 2 weeks, and I live in an ungated community, and my fans know where I live at, and all this shit, and all that other shit. That shit sound like some bullshit. Bitch, you trying to postpone Nia moving in? Why? I don't know. Maybe you ain't have time to clean the fucking house like you want it clean, if you know what I'm saying. You know what I'm saying? So, I don't know what's up with that, bitch. What do y'all think about that? Why the fuck is he trying to make Nia wait? Is he really worried about Nia's security? Or, bitch, do you think it's something else? Leave it in the comment section. Bitch, so now we got Berg, Ray J, and Sincere, and they look like they in a club drinking as usual or whatever. And Ray J telling them what happened that caused him to be in jail, bitch. And didn't I fucking tell y'all that Ray J wanted some type of street credit for going to jail? That nigga was like, bitch, it's as if he seen the review. Ding. Okay. Bitch, it's as if he seen the review or something, bitch. Because he was like, man, the same thing I fucking said. Man, I did 9, you heard me? Like, what you did, 9 years? No, nigga. 9 months? No, nigga. 9 weeks? No, nigga. 9 hours. He was like, damn, I can't even get credit for that shit. I went to jail for 9 hours in Beverly Hills. So now we got Berg telling them what's going on with Tiara and all that. And bitch, Sincere, messy ass gonna be like, well, how was the pussy? Bitch, while Ray J sitting right there, bitch, how messy is that, girl? That was so fucking petty. And Berg was like, well, I never had it or whatever. Me and Tiara is keeping it 100% business, okay? We gonna see how long that lasts, though, Berg. Bitch, now we got Nikki and her dried up ass mama. Bitch, and I usually don't go in on the mamas, but bitch, that hoe don't act like no mama. So, bitch, I'm not gonna treat her like one, okay? Bitch, so now we got Nikki and her dried up ass mama, bitch, on Sunset Boulevard because Nikki wanted her mama to see the billboard or whatever. So they sitting down talking, and Nikki was like, don't act like you don't see that billboard behind me. And her mama was basically like, girl, look, Sam got a lease to the fucking club, bitch. He could have whoever he want on his fucking billboard to his fucking club. And bitch, there's nothing we could do about it, really. And then this dumb bitch Nikki comes back on the fucking screen saying, because I can get it taken off if I really want to. Bitch, your mama just said, bitch, he got a lease and he could have whoever the fuck he want on there, bitch. So why? What makes you think you could still get it taken down, girl? Like, what's the tea? And bitch, like, this is gonna be a little spoiler. So if y'all don't want a little spoiler, y'all might as well fast forward just a few seconds. Okay? Now, y'all know the tea is that she supposedly put that fucking mugshot up on that billboard, right? Girl, that is too fucking petty, bitch. Petty, okay? But then, bitch, Nikki mama pulls out a fucking mugshot of Masika, girl. Yes, bitch, done Googled the mugshot of the girl, printed it out, and bought it to her little meetup with Nikki. That's why I don't respect her as a mama, because, bitch, you being petty. Petty, bitch. What's the tea with that? But I mean, everybody have a past, you know what I'm saying? The girl was young. She was with a group of people. They went to jail. So fucking what? You know what I'm saying? That don't give you the right to put the girl fucking mugshot on a billboard, bitch. No, ma'am. Bitch, so then Fizz and Monice meets up to talk about what happened with Amanda, bitch. So Amanda trying to tell Fizz, you know, what actually happened. And Fizz, like, cutting her off, bitch. Fizz is not trying to hear that shit. All Fizz know is he coming out to check this hole because Amanda done checked him on some shit, basically. Now we got Ray J driving with this slow-ass music playing. And his lawyer calls him and tells him that he got 3 years probation and he have to take anger management classes. Now, bitch, I ain't gonna even lie, bitch. That is not a slap on the wrist, okay? Probation is really not a slap on the wrist. And them fucking anger management classes, bitch. As a lot of y'all know, bitch, I had to take anger management classes, girl. And I successfully completed my course. But, bitch, it was not an easy task at all. Okay? Because, I mean, you just get aggravated because you got people telling you how not to get mad and what not to do to get mad and all this other shit. And it's making you mad because you got to sit in here and deal with this bullshit and listen to all this dumb shit. But, bitch, my anger management teacher was fine as a motherfucker, bitch. And now it's weird because I actually be seeing him at school and shit. I didn't know that he was, like, in school, bitch. So, I don't know, bitch. I might have to make my way in one of them fucking substance abuse classes he in, bitch. Just take that, bitch. And it could be an elective, okay? Just to be in a class with him, bitch. That bitch gonna know the tea, bitch. Because I'm gonna come in class late, bitch, and sit next to him every day. Okay. Bitch, so now the scene changes to Tierra and Nikki out having a drink or whatever. And Nikki noticed that they have an extra glass or whatever. So she like, what you trying to set me up on a blind date, bitch? And then Masika walks up. And Nikki like, ugh, this is who you invited over here? Like, for real. So, bitch, Masika started telling her how she felt or whatever. Keeping it real with that whole Nikki. Then Nikki starts talking stupid about taking the fucking billboard down, bitch. And then she winds up fucking leaving, girl. Bitch, not April water done broke, child. Bitch, it's time to set this pool up, get this bitch in the pool so we can deliver this fucking baby. So, now we got Ray J meeting up with his daddy or whatever, and he's telling his daddy that he got 3 years on probation and he got anger management classes and all this and all that. And you could just tell he's frustrated already. Bitch, I ain't been in that one class yet and mad already. So his daddy is basically telling him, well, son, maybe them anger management classes might do you some good so you can have a better control over your actions and shit. You know what I'm saying? And they do make you think about your actions. Then his daddy started talking about Tierra, some type of way they started talking about Tierra. And Ray J was like, yeah, mama always talking about how she liked Tierra and this and this and that. And Ray J told his daddy how he dismissed her or whatever the last time they met. And his daddy was like, you need to apologize for that shit. And Ray J finally admitted that he fucked over that girl. Now I could kind of respect you for being a man and admitting that you fucked over Tierra, bitch. So that girl wasn't delusional and wasn't lying, bitch. You fucked over that girl. And that's fucked up, Ray J. Okay. So, bitch, now we're back to April and Omarion, bitch. And she, like, having a baby and shit, child. Like, in the pool, for real, bitch. Yes. Okay? Like, didn't that part make y'all feel some type of way? Like, you know? So, that's basically what happened on this episode of Love & Hip Hop Hollywood, Season 1, Episode 9. I'm your boy, New Orleans Lil. Thanks for tuning in. If this your first time tuned into the channel, make sure you subscribe, thumbs up, and leave a comment down below. You heard me? Peace. But first, hey, diddle, diddle, got Lil in the middle. Want the host to subscribe and comment just a little. Hey, hey, diddle, diddle, got Lil in the middle. Want the host to subscribe and comment just a little. Now leave your fucking comment. Work your fucking comment. Write your fucking comment. Mix your fucking comment. Now leave your fucking comment. Work your fucking comment. Write your fucking comment. Mix your fucking comment. Leave your comment. Work your comment. Write your comment. Mix your comment. Leave your comment. Work your comment. Write your comment. Mix your comment. Leave your comment. Work your comment. Write your comment. Mix your comment. Mix, mama. Mix, mix, mama. Mix, mix. Mix, mama. Mix, mix, mama. Mix, mix. Mix, mama. Mix, mix, mama. Mix, mix. Peace. It's your boy, New Orleans Lil.